The presidential address by Professor Dr. G.M. Nair, President, Kerala Academy of Sciences. Professor G.M. Nair is a distinguished academician and a scientist in the field of plant sciences. He has held various positions in the academic field, starting as reader in botany, University of Kerala, and retired as professor and head of department. He was the former director of KCST JNT BJRI Palur Thiruvananthapuram. He also served as Dean of Science in Central University of Kerala, Kasaragod. Currently, he is the president of Kerala Academy of Sciences and also the director of Central Laboratory for Instrumentation and Facilitation, University of Kerala. Sir, I cordially welcome you to give the presidential address.
Thank you. Let me at the outset welcome each one of you to this international webinar, as well as to the Dr. Hisham Endowment Award Function. Professor, respected Professor Chandrabhas Narayana, Dr. Umman V. Umman, Professor Sudhakaran, Professor Unnikrishnan, and all the other dignitaries who have gathered today to witness this great inaugural ceremony of the International Webinar on Phytochemistry Impacts and Applications. I'm particularly happy on this day, mainly because there was something great happened yesterday to Kerala. The topmost being a Bhatnagar, Shanti Swarup Bhatnagar Award being brought in by Dr. Jimon, Epidemiology Department of the Achyutamenon Center of Sri Chitra Thirumal Institute of Medical Sciences and Technology. This is something, maybe that every year we are getting one or two Bhatnagar awardees, and that is great for the Kerala science, for the progress of Kerala science. I'm also extremely happy that yesterday I heard that CSIR NIST has received an appreciation as the best technology award from the CSIR. I'm also extremely happy two of the junior colleagues of Dr. Chandrabhas Narayana from JNCSIR and Dr. Bishwas and Dr. Govinda Raju have also bagged two Bhatnagar awards in the same discipline in an institute. It is a great thing. I'm sure that you are excited and you are cherishing this great recognition that's given to your parent institution. Congratulations, Dr. Chandrabhas. Congratulations, Dr. Jimon. Congratulations, CSIR NIST. We are all proud of you all. But another award, maybe that is a step to the Nobel Prize, you know, because if at the young age you get the award, probably they should get this as a stepping stone for getting working hard to strive to the level of Nobel Prize. I'm sorry for my bad throat. I have a very bad throat. I won't be able to speak for more, but I'm extremely happy to welcome you all to this event, great event, where we have Dr. Chandrabhas Narayana giving a well-known academician and a scientist who is now the director of Rajiv Gandhi Center for Biotechnology. The most important and the most prestigious national institutes of the country. Welcome you, sir, on my behalf of this project. We have been Kerala Academy of Sciences with an assistance from the family of Dr. Hisham has been organizing a phytochemistry seminar and Dr. Hisham Endowment Award lecture and an endowment award since 2015. Last year also, because of the pandemic, we had held this program in the online platform, and this time also we are holding it in the online platform. And next time I feel it would be in a physical meeting. Hopes that we will be away from Corona COVID-19 pandemic, and we will be able to bring back normalcy to the country, to the world. Kerala Academy of Sciences has been organizing a number of programs, like Dr. Ramesh Kumar has already narrated the events that have happened in Kerala Academy of Sciences. We stand for promoting science, scientific excellence, as well as taking science to the society. We arrange several programs. We move to different parts of the state of Kerala to inculcate science and scientific timber among the youth of Kerala, especially the school children. We feel that is a great thing, because like what we have as a Bhatnagar Awards, you know, coming in to Kerala, maybe that we this should be eye opener to the youngsters to opt for science, to come to science, to do work hard, because such awards won't come easily. It is necessary that you should work very hard, and I'm sure that we have all the ambience in the state of Kerala. We have great research institutes. We have almost all the facilities available to carry out excellent international research in the country, in the state of Kerala. So this is something which people should understand, and also that it's also what is important to remember that whenever you take up a research, you should commit yourself. You should understand what is around you, happening around you. Try to frame a program which would be accepted in international journals for very good publications. As well, that you need to think about social. Please, you should also remember that we have a responsibility to the society, the scientific social responsibility. Like what we do in Kerala Academy of Sciences, everyone knows you that it's not that all the research that you carry out should end up in a publication or in a patent, but also that it should reach the society as a product or a process. I was very happy to read the citations of regarding Dr. Jimon, how exactly the cardiology problems have been resolved by him through his outstanding work, which led to the award of the Bhatnagar Award. So maybe that we have ample opportunities here in Kerala. We have the ambience to carry out outstanding research. We have very good expertise available, either in service or out of service, but people are there to help you all in all the ways that you want. We have the support of all the academic excellence, infrastructure, everything is available, including the facility that is available in the Central Laboratory for Instrumentation and Facilitation, which I am representing now. So what I feel is that everything is there in front of you. You need to shape it up and bring it to bring laurels to the state of Kerala, to the country, as well as to the world. This program, the phytochemistry webinar, this time we have widened the scope for going into allied disciplines, because we thought that phytochemistry should not be the only one that should be dealt with. It is the application of phytochemistry for valuable medicines, like we have, are there any valuable molecules in the plant system which could go for treating corona or COVID-19. We have ample scope for getting medicines for dengue, because I'm sure two of my friends, one in ICGB New Delhi, he has got a Wellcome Trust Foundation backing for making a drug, a plant-based drug for dengue. And also I know Dr. Subhash Vasudevan from India, Singapore, is also in the verge of marketing a product which would address the problem of dengue. So I'm sure that there are molecules available in the plant kingdom around you, not only in the plant kingdom, but in the biological system as a whole. What is needed is that to identify those great molecules available in the biomolecules, identify the potential of them, evaluate them, as well as take them as a molecule which would address many of those problems which are ailing humankind. And that would be the social responsibility that even a phytochemist should take up, not just identifying the chemical molecules. Maybe that a phytochemist may not be able to go in for making translational research. Probably there are people in the phytopharmacology divisions, in the biochemistry, in all the other, in the medical systems, which could join hand with the phytochemist, wherein we are going to listen to people about the molecules that they have identified, but connect it well to the phytopharmacological system, to the medical system, go for evaluating them, their efficacy in addressing many of those. And I'm sure that this is going to be a wonderful time for all, in front of all of us, to to understand the potential of phytochemistry, to understand the potential of phytopharmacology, and then going for making valuable medicines for the benefit of mankind. As I said, I have the problems. I don't want to prolong it, but I take this opportunity to welcome you all once again to this great international conference on phytochemistry, the prospects and applications, as well to the proceedings that is happening subsequently. I'm sure that today you're going to have an exciting time for that. And before I conclude, I would also congratulate Dr. Meenu IMT from CSIR NIST, who has backed this year's coveted Dr. Hisham Endowment Award. Congratulations, Meenu. Congratulations, Jimon from SCTI MST, and congratulations, NIST, and maybe that we will be able to congratulate many in the years to come. Thank you very much, and you have a wonderful time ahead. Thank you.